Before you start any exercise or piece or anything, you should really have a free feeling of the breath. Breath is so important to piano playing. And I always take a nice natural inhale and I blow out into the beginning notes of anything, whether it's an upbeat or a downbeat, no matter. I'm always breathing, slow breathing exhale into the opening notes of a piece or an exercise. So don't get tight. The Russian school also teaches, and they work with the children a lot, going from the child's hand in the lap with the draping arm and then to the piano like this. So they work a lot with the follow-through motion, the relaxed motion, just showing you so we never get like that. So if I take the inhale, I have the one and two. That follow through motion. Now you notice when I did the 16th notes, I'm going toward G. That gives you an example of that. And the left hand mimics the other hand because you have, again, the down up motions. When I say down, I don't mean you're falling down. I mean you're level, but you're coming. Together, you take your inhale and here and back and roll and two and three and four and double, yeah, so your destination note is that top note, but it's not an angular destination. It's a curve around round destination. So to make the roundness, with the wrist helping to be a shock absorber to the fingers, it really is a shock absorber. It stops you from pencil pointing or poking at the top note and getting that sharp sound instead of the curve around. Never start with a punch because it's a slope. This whole exercise is sloping up, so you're never going to go da da di. Always roll in. Minor and take your inhale. Remember, it's a slope, so you can't fall down hard on the first note because the first note is going somewhere to the top note that's curving around, so it's not angular top, it's circular top, curve around. Down an octave below middle C in the right hand, and then left is an octave below that, because we'll be adding octave. We do that same principle of quarter notes, eighth notes, sixteenths, but when you get to the top, the motion's a little different. One and two. Now what I do a little bit more, I get the thumb under rather quickly. is under quickly. Top note, when I got to the 16th, I wanted it to be just drawn out a little bit, and in fact, the sequence of events, my wrist rolled forward the top roll. The resolution note, that's going to be the longer note. Roll. As if we have a whole note at the end, right? Forward, back. It's just a longer note at the end. Okay, now on the old French song, again, we need that rolling motion always. We don't want to get a tappy finger sound. We see a phrase with a slur, it means it's a bundled group of notes that has to go somewhere. And these notes have to go somewhere. They go to there. That's decaying. Roll around to there. Def. And then echo. Crescendo. Then what's coming next is an echo of that, but you have the traction through the honey. So it's traction and honey. But I still need now to go to the dominant here. Now even if you do the fingering on that second phrase the same with the three the first time, that's okay, to 12. Then you go back to 1, 2, 3, 1, crescendo there. And you can do some separate hands too. Like the left hand is rolling as well, but it's going to be less arm weight because it's the under voice. These are two voices here, about a tenor voice and a bass voice. So shape everything. Let's a little lean and fall down. Dominant, resolve. Now most of my dynamics are going to be upstairs, so even if I have a dominant in the left hand, I'm not going to punch that out because it will drown out the beautiful vocalist on top, the song. So when you get to that dominant measure, don't let a lot of students say, okay, I did the crescendo, now I'm going to smash down on my dominant chord, but it'll drown out the singer. So you can't do that. So the balance is really upstairs. Look how less the left hand is. Echo upstairs. Crescendo. See, it's done in the right hand. See, it's the right hand, basically. That's going to be hard because when students say, oh, one hand's doing crescendo, the other hand starts doing the crescendo too. And then the left hand is overbalancing the right hand. So we're going to work a lot on balance. So I would suggest a lot of separate hands. Less. But you still contour it. You have to still have some leaning notes, but they're still going to be underneath the right hand. Thank you. shape the notes down, dominant real song. And again, together. About this piece is if you have a flat design, it doesn't always work. You have to say each time I do the same thing over and over, I'm going to do something a little different. That this is expression music, expression period music, late romantic. So each time, the thing is that when you see so much of the same, if you play it all the same, it doesn't have the expression that you need. It's a bit sophisticated, and the use of the wrist and everything takes time to get the flow and let go. You have to really let go of what is tight here and let it loose and let the arms play like a dancer. You're really coming down your arms into your wrists and your relaxed hands, and you're making sure your thumbs aren't tight. You're going through the honey. There are all of these properties of playing that it's almost that you can't verbalize it, but you can show it. You can show the dragging of the notes through the honey. You can show the seamless legato so that you don't get tappy fingers. What you want to do with the staccato is don't let it go up and down. You want it to go across, and what I do to avoid that vertical punch up and down is I roll it first in legato. How do I want to do it? Start doing a legato staccato and then I snip it, I get more of a horizontal staccato. And that's what's going to happen in your scales eventually, where you do. You're going to snip it. You're just going to let go of your whatever choreography you had and your rolling arms and your rolling wrists. And you're just going to snip the ends of your fingers, and you'll still have a nice shape to your staccato instead of like bullet point kinds of staccato. I think it's going to show. We'll see how that video comes through.